How are you all? Students, I believe that you all have enjoyed the festival of siblings love in a very memorable way. And now you all are settled down for today's lecture. So, today we are going to start chapter 16 of your grammar book, that is direct and indirect speech. Students, it is called direct and indirect speech. It is called reported speech and narrations also. Now, obviously, grammar topic is there, so rules and regulations are a must to be followed. But before that, let's know which statement is called a direct speech or which statement is called an indirect speech. Students, there are two ways to speak something. I am talking to you. I first person, you second person. That is direct speech. Speech divided into two parts, direct speech and indirect speech. If first person means I and we. If first person talks to second person, that is direct speech. If second person talks to third person, then it is called indirect speech. When first person talks to second person, it is direct speech. If second person talks to third person about first person, that is called indirect speech. I am talking to you. Clearly, I can convey my message. But sometimes it happens that the speaker cannot convey the message directly. Then direct speech is required. I am giving a message for whole class and I cannot come to the whole class. I cannot come in the class. What will I do? I'll convey the message through the leader of the class that you are supposed to announce in the class that tomorrow the test of so and so will be conducted. I am talking to you. I am talking to the leader directly, but leader is conveying my message to the third people, to the third person. That is called students indirect speech. Every sentence has some format to be written. So let's see if we will get our sentence in direct form, then that will be in which form? Look here. Students, the sentence which you will get of direct speech, it will be in this form. First of all, reporting clause will be there. Reporting clause means who speaks. Here it is mentioned. Who speaks to whom, or sometimes to me is not written, only John said. So who speaks, that is mentioned in reporting clause. The actual words spoken by the speaker are mentioned in the reported clause. Who speak to whom, or sometimes who speaks, that is called reporting clause, and the actual words spoken by the speaker are called reported clause. They are divided by comma, inverted comma. Always remember this format. Now, what are the rules to be followed? In which way we can convert the direct into indirect? Let's learn in detail. So students, here we have our chapter number 16, direct and indirect speech. Students, we may report the words of a speaker in two ways. First way is direct speech and another is indirect speech. Now let's understand by an example. Suresh said, I can solve this sum. The way of reporting the actual words of a speaker is called direct speech. The actual words spoken are put within inverted commas. Further, we have another way. Suresh said that
he could solve that sum. When we give the substance an idea of what the speaker has said, the form of speech is called the indirect speech or reported speech. And always remember that no inverted commas are used in indirect form. Further, I have already told you at the time of introduction that the format, the way of expressing a sentence of direct speech would be in which way. It will be divided into two parts. First is reporting clause, another is reported clause. In reporting clause, it is an utterance like she asked, she said, they informed, etc. Like in the above example, Suresh said is the reporting clause. Next we have reported clause. In reported clause, the words uttered by the speaker are mentioned. In the above sentence which we read just now, Suresh said I can solve this sum. Suresh said is reporting clause, and I can solve this sum, it is reported clause. Further we have rules, or in which format we will be getting our sentence. The very first is, in direct speech, the actual words of the speaker are put within inverted commas. We have already discussed that. The reported speech is separated from the reporting clause by comma or a colon. The first word of the reported speech begins with a capital letter. Next we have, in the indirect speech, no inverted commas are used. The comma at the end of the reporting verb is removed in indirect speech. The reported speech begins with some conjunction like that, if, what, why, etc. That we will surely learn in further explanation, that in which cases that will be used, where if or any WH family member will be used. Next we have, the tense of the reporting clause is never changed. Yes students, always remember, if it is he said to me means past, so the tense of reporting clause will never be changed, but the verb changes according to the tense. Only full stop is used at the end of the indirect speech, whether assertive sentence is there, exclamatory, interrogative, imperative, any kind of sentence is there. And when we convert from direct into indirect, then it always ends with a full stop. Further, rules for change of pronoun. Students, very simple way to learn the rules for change of pronoun is this: son upon 123 or 123, anything you can say, means first person changes according to the subject of the reporting clause. Second person changes according to the object of the reporting clause, and pronoun of the third person do not change. I am repeating, pronoun of the first person changes according to the subject of the reporting clause. Pronoun of the second person changes according to the object of the reporting clause. Pronoun of the third person, he, she, it, any name is there, then they do not change. Let's understand through examples. Look here. The very first example is written, he said, I write a letter. Students, whenever you are supposed to change direct into indirect, always underline or always remember, in direct speech, which changes you are supposed to do. The very first change would be of this comma, inverted comma. Then I will be changed. Then verb form will be changed. Comma will, inverted comma will be removed. Now let's change direct into indirect. He said, to remove this comma, inverted comma, we will write that. Who is I here? He. So here also we will write he. First form changes into second form, means present indefinite changes into past indefinite. So write will be changed into wrote, and object will be the same, that is a letter. So what would be the indirect transformation? He said I write this letter. He said that he wrote a letter. Let's see another one. He said to me, you write a letter. Here not only said is there, but said to is there. Remember, said to is changed into told. He told me to remove comma, inverted comma. What will we add? That. Who is you here? He said to me. You is second person, and second person changes according to the object of reporting clause. You will be changed into I. Write first form, that will be changed into second form. And here is our sentence. He told me that I wrote a letter. Further are the changes of words expressing time. This you need to remember, my dear students. Today changes into that day. Yesterday, the previous day, or the day before. Tomorrow, the next day, the following day. Tonight, the night before, or the previous night. Next week, next year, the following week, year. Last week, year, the previous week, now, then, ago, before, just, then. These are the changes which you need to remember while changing direct into indirect. Let's understand the words expressing nearness. What would be the transformation of these words from direct to indirect? This will be changed into that, these, those, here, there, hither, thither, thus, so. Students, there are many examples in your book through which we can understand. But before understanding the sentences, let's understand the auxiliaries. If any particular helping verb is there, if any particular tense is there, then what are the changes which we need to do? Like, if in any sentence am is there, that will be changed into was. Is changes into was. Are changes into were. Has have into had. Shall, should, will, would, can, could, may, might. These are the changes in auxiliaries. Now let's understand with example. Sarita said, I shall go to Hapur tomorrow. Now which changes we are supposed to do? The very first change is of comma, inverted comma, then of first person, then tense, then time. So these are the changes which we are supposed to do. And since in reporting clause there is no object, so said will remain said only. Sarita said, to remove comma, inverted comma, what will we add? That. Sarita said that. Who is I? Sarita, first person changes according to the subject of the reporting clause. She would go to Hapur the next day. Tomorrow changes into the next day. Now you would ask, why would is there? Because with I and we use shall. If second or third person is there, then will or would is added. Shall will be changed into should. But if second and third person is there, then it will be changed into would. Further we have these examples. He said, my friend lives here. He said that his friend lived there. These are the changes in nearness. Now students, let's understand in which cases the tense in reported speech will be changed. First of all, always remember students, these are the rules that are used to change from direct into indirect. Simple present changes into simple past. Present progressive changes into past progressive. Present perfect into past perfect and so on. But these are the changes, my dear students, if the reporting verb is in past. Remember, these changes will occur. You are supposed to do these changes if the reporting verb is in past. But if not, then what? If reporting verb are in present or in future, then definitely in reported speech, tense will not be changed. How? Let's understand. Direct form. Naresh says. Says means first form plus S or ES. Means present indefinite. So, if present tense is there, we have already learnt that tense of reported clause will not be changed. Naresh says, Ram is happy. So, the indirect form would be, Naresh says that Ram is happy. Ram is third person, so no change. Is will remain is only, that will not be changed into was, because in reporting clause, present tense has been used. Let's see another example for understanding what changes would be there if future tense is there in reporting verb. He will say, I reached there in time. He will say, that will remain same because we know that in reporting verb, no change is allowed. So, he will say, to remove comma, inverted comma, that will be written. Who is I? That is he. Reached, which is the second form of the verb, that will remain same in the sentence and rest of the sentence also. He will say that he reached there in time. And further, I have already told you students, if reporting verb is in past, then these are the certain rules which are to be followed while changing from direct into indirect. But students, in everything, exceptions are there. I have said that if reporting verb is in past, then the tenses of the verbs will be changed. But there are some exceptions also. Beta, if the direct speech expresses a universal truth or habitual fact, the tense of the verb does not change. How? He said, reporting clause is in past, but further, reported clause has a universal fact. So, the tense will not be changed, that will remain same in indirect form. He said that the sun sets in the west. Satish said, I am a late riser. Satish said that he is a late riser. Obviously, to remove comma, inverted comma, we will write that we will change first person according to the reporting clause, that we will do, but we are not allowed, we are not supposed to change the tense of reported clause. Next, you need to learn, students, if there are two clauses in the reported speech and both of them are in past tense, then tense of the verb does not change. Hari said to me, he was busy, so he didn't talk to anyone. The conversion would be, instead of said to, told will be used. To remove comma, inverted comma, that will be used. Hari told me that he was busy, so he did not talk to anyone. There are two clauses in reported speech, so the tense will not be changed. Next, we have, if a particular situation exists while reporting, then the tense of the reported speech does not change. How? The department head said the teachers are not teaching because the principal has denied their request. The situation continues to be unchanged at the time of reporting, so its indirect form would be, the department had told that the teachers are not teaching because the principal has denied their request. So if any situation is there that continues to be unchanged at the time of reporting, then also tense will not be changed. Let's understand more with the help of examples which are given in your exercise 1. The boy said, I want a new pen. The boy said, now let's underline first of all which changes you are supposed to do. To remove comma, inverted comma, we will write that I will be changed, first person will be changed according to the subject of reporting clause. Want is the first form, means simple present is there, that will be changed into simple past, and rest will be the same. So the answer would be, the boy said that he wanted a new pen. I hope it's clear to all of you. So students, till now we have understood about direct and indirect speech. What are the changes in time, changes in tenses, and changes in assertive sentences? Now it's time to understand what changes will be there if in reported clause an interrogative sentence is there. First of all, let's know about the rules. In interrogative sentences, said or said to of reporting verb are replaced with asked or enquired. If the interrogative begins with helping verb or modal, is, am, are, do, does, was, were, has, have, had, will, shall, and so on, then after removing inverted commas, we write if or whether conjunction. Inverted commas are replaced with the conjunction if or whether. If the interrogative begins with WH family, then we do not use if or whether. They are not replaced with if or whether, but they are used as it is in indirect form also. Whichsoever WH family member is there, why, what, which, when, whichever, that will be used as it is. If there are no interrogatives in indirect speech, we place helping verb or modal after the subject, because we are supposed to convert direct into indirect, and in indirect form we convert an interrogative sentence into an assertive or affirmative one. Let's understand with an example. The teacher said, have you completed your homework? Have WH family member is there, or any helping verb is there? Yes, it is helping verb. So let's see the change. The teacher, in place of said to, asked will be used. To remove comma, inverted comma, if will be used. Have is used before subject. It is an interrogative sentence, but we are supposed to make it an assertive sentence. So definitely we will be using helping verb after subject. You, second person, will be changed into object of reporting clause. We, us, will be transformed into we. Completed, second form is there, that will be changed into had plus third form. So the transformation would be, the teacher asked us if we had completed our homework, and at the end full stop will be used. Next we have, he said to me. Let's take another example in which WH family member is used. Here it is. Ravi said to him, what have you learnt? Ravi asked him, obviously a question is there. So Ravi asked him what, that will remain as it is in indirect speech. Who is you? According to object, it will be changed. What he had learnt, has have changes into had. So these are the changes in interrogative sentence. If helping verbs have been used, then if and whether conjunction will be used. If interrogative begins with a WH family, then they are not replaced by conjunction at all. They are used as it is in the indirect speech. So your exercise number 2 is based on interrogative sentences. I hope you can try yourself first. Now let's understand change of imperative sentences. As we all know, students, whenever we give any command, any order, request, advice, or we forbid something, these sentences are called imperative sentences, and this is the same way to change from direct to indirect. Students, in assertive sentences, to remove comma, inverted comma, we have used that. But remember, in indirect speech, when we will be changing imperative sentences, then we will be using to. How? Let's understand. First of all, let's see the definition. In changing the imperative sentences into the indirect form of speech, the reporting verb say is changed into command, order, request, advise, forbid, etc. The imperative mood is changed into the infinitive mood. Infinitive means to will be added. So by placing to before the verb. In a negative imperative, the auxiliary do is dropped and to is placed after not. Let is changed into suggested or proposed. Let's understand through example. My father said to the servant, open the door. Obviously, it is an order. So, said to will be changed into order. Obviously, it will be changed into order. I have already told you, comma, inverted comma will be changed into to, that will be replaced by to, and rest of the sentence will be as it is. So the indirect transformation, my father ordered the servant to open the door. Let's see another. He said to me, work hard. He advised me. Imperative sentence is there, so definitely said to will be changed into command, order, request, advice, etc. So he advised me to work hard. That is the indirect transformation of imperative sentences. Next type of sentences are exclamatory sentences, and now we are going to learn how can we change exclamatory sentences from direct to indirect. Obviously, students, if exclamatory sentence is there, then I will एक्सक्लेम विद सोरो, एक्सक्लेम विद जॉय, सरप्राइज, अपलोडेड, कन्फेस्ड और आई विल विश समथिंग. ओनली दीज सेंटेंसेज आर कॉल्ड एक्सक्लेमेटरी सेंटेंसेज एंड द सेम वी आर गोइंग टू यूज इन रिपोर्टिंग क्लोज. द इंटरजेक्शन एंड एक्सक्लेमेशंस आर ड्रॉप्ड. वर्ड लाइक हाउ, बिग आर चेंज्ड इनटू वेरी एंड ग्रेट. लेट्स अंडरस्टैंड थ्रू एग्जाम्पल. डायरेक्ट स्पीच. द ओल्ड वुमन सेड, मे गॉड ब्लेस यू विद लॉन्ग लाइफ. शी इज प्रेइंग, शी इज विशिंग. सो इन द सेम वे वी आर गोइंग टू चेंज इन रिपोर्टिंग. द वुमन प्रेड दैट गॉड माइट ब्लेस मी विद लॉन्ग लाइफ. द सेम चेंजेस विल बी देयर इन रिपोर्टिंग क्लोज. सेड विल बी चेंज्ड इन टू प्रेड. It will be to remove comma, inverted comma, that will be used, and this exclamatory sentence will be transferred, will be transformed into assertive sentence. So what would be the transformation? Definitely God is subject, that will be used before helping verb. God may changes into might. Bless you. Who is you here? Me. With long life. Let's see another. She said, alas, I am ruined. Alas means exclaimed with sorrow, a matter of deep sorrow. So she exclaimed with sorrow that she was ruined. I is first person, that will be changed according to the subject in reporting clause. So she was ruined. In the same way, students go through with the types of assertive, exclamatory, imperative and interrogative, and which sentence is called direct speech or indirect speech. For any doubt, keep your questions ready in Zoom classes. Till then, exercises 1 to 4 you need to complete. God bless you children. Goodbye.